and welcome back to another video of Architects 3DP. Today I'm bringing you the assembly of the JGAURORA or JGMAKER Magic, the 3D printer we unboxed in the last video, and I recommend you to watch clicking here in the top right corner or in the link in the description. The JGMAKER Magic is a surprisingly good 3D printer that I got for only 225 euros on Amazon. I will let you the link in the description, by the way, in case you want to buy it. I will publish very soon the video covering the review and comparison of this nice 3D printer. Now, I'm going to start with assembly. But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, it will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. Alright, so to build the 3D printer, I'm gonna use the included instructions, where as I said in the last episode, everything is very well explained and correctly translated into English. So what I'm gonna do is to put all the steps from the manual on the screen and then assembly it, repeating this process until we finish the build. Okay, so I'm going to start with the X-axis. For what we'll need, this 20x20 V-slot profile, the X-right module, and the X-left module. You have to orient the long space on the left and the short one on the right. Then we'll use the holes in the profile to host these heads of the bolts, what will keep the modules in the correct position. So once we have the components, first step will be, as you can see, to assemble them together. As I said, we're gonna orient the module right like this. To install it, we'll orient the T-type nuts to fit in the slot, and then use the Allen key to tighten them in place. As personal advice, I would recommend you to, once inserted in place, turn the bolt anti-clockwise a couple turns, and then turn it clockwise to tighten it in place. This will make the whole process much easier. So that was the first one, and now we're gonna go for the second one. Remember, exact same process. Alright, so first step, complete. Do you see how easy it is? Now I'm gonna continue with the second step, for which we're gonna need the extruder module, the idler module, and the timing belt. As you can see here in the instructions, we'll install the idler on the left, then, very important, put the timing belt in place, and finally insert the extruder block. So once said, I'm gonna place the belt here, then insert the extruder block from the right, just like so, and finally set the idler in place. Notice that you shouldn't tighten these bolts too much yet, since we're going to use the idler to put some tension on the belts. So I'm going to install it in place just like so, and then insert one of the ends of the belt here on the left, and the other one on the right. That's why the belt had some zip ties on the ends, as we were wondering in the unboxing. Now yes, we're gonna pull from the idler and tighten the bolts in place, getting this nice and tight X-axis build. Now I'm gonna build the Z-axis according to the instructions. For what I'm gonna need first, one of the 20x40mm profiles, the Z-axis motor, and the Z-axis endstop, that we'll put together using one of the included Allen keys. According to the instructions, we'll install first the motor to the profile, making sure it lies flat on a table, and then tighten the end stop in place. Notice that we could need to remove the coupling. Okay, so it's gonna be mounted just like this. First, I'm gonna tighten the motor, making sure it lies flat on the table. And once we have it, I'm gonna slide in the Z end stop just like so. For the second step of the Z-axis, we're gonna need a couple more components. First, the second 20x40mm profile. And I'm gonna make some space, because we'll also need the base of the 3D printer, where we are going to attach the 20x40mm profiles using these 4 M5x40mm bolts. So to install them, make sure you orient the profiles like me, and now just insert the bolts in place and use the Allen key to tighten them. That was one. And two. This is already starting to look like a 3D printer. Now that we have each of the axes assembled separately, it's time to put them together and start building the 3D printer itself.
So first step, according to the instructions, will be to fit the x-axis into the rest of the build. So very easy step, I'm gonna just insert it in place. As you can see, it fits perfectly. Next, we'll install the 20x20mm profile that we have left on top of the vertical profiles using the M5x25mm bolts. So here we have it, and here we have the bolts too. I'm gonna put it here on top and insert the bolts with my fingers. Once all of them are in place, we'll tighten them using the Allen key, as you can see here. The next step, according to the manual, will be to install the decoration. So here we go! First, we'll insert one screw here in this side, and the other one right on the other side. As always, once in place, we'll tighten both of them with the Allen key. Alright, so next step, install the Z-axis TA threaded rod. For that, I'm gonna turn the 3D printer around, since we'll need to work with these two elements right here, the nut and the flexible coupling. So we'll pick up the threaded rod and we'll remove the protective plastic just like so. Once done, we'll insert it to the nut till we reach the coupling at the bottom. So we'll start screwing it manually, and with a bit of patience, we'll insert it till we get to the bottom. Once here, we'll release the pressure of the screw on top, till we can insert the lead screw like this. Then we'll tighten it back using the Allen key. And as you can see, we can try to move it manually, which works perfect. Once we make sure everything is working fine, we'll apply more pressure on the bolts of the coupling, and we'll be ready to go! Next step in the instructions will be to install the filament sensor with the two M3x8mm bolts, so that's what I'm gonna do now. I've picked up the bolts and the sensor, so now I'm gonna place it here and insert and tighten the bolts. Easy! Next, we'll install the fitting suit. Once we have it, we'll install the motor from below. Make sure to orient the connector of the cables like me. And here we have it! Alright, so next component, the filament holder. We'll need for that the filament holder itself and the two M5x8mm bolts. It's gonna be mounted right here, so we'll insert the bolts that will hold it in place. And once we have all of them in, we'll tighten them. Doesn't it look cool already?
We're getting to the end of the assembly, guys. All the components are in place, and the only thing left we need to do
will be to connect the cables in place according to the instructions. So that's what I'm gonna do now. The first we'll need to do is to remove the protective plastic that is covering the cables. And once they are free, we're going to start by plugging in the filament sensor, that as you can see is properly tagged as extruder switch. Next, we'll plug in the Z end stop, tagged as Z switch, just like so. Next, the extruder motor, also perfectly tagged. And we're gonna also connect the X-axis motor, that is right here next to it, as you can see.
The Y-axis has been pre-connected from the factory, so the only axis left to connect will be the Z-axis.
That is the one I'm going to connect right now, here at the bottom. And last but not least, the last connector we'll need to plug in will be the one coming to the extruder block. And we are done!
Apparently, this is the last hardware iteration we need to do with this 3D printer before starting with our first print. However, there are a couple more steps that are not in the manual, and I strongly recommend you to do.
First, the bowden tube is not connected to anything, so we'll need to plug it in somewhere. And this somewhere is right here, into this black hole in the feeder. Second, we'll need to cut these two zip ties that were protecting the Y-axis during the shipping, but we don't need here anymore, so we'll cut them, but be very careful and do not cut the timing belt. Alright, now the axis can move freely. And third and last, we'll install the extruder cable through this nice fastener on top of the extruder block, what will keep our extruder nice and organized.
The build, guys, is complete, and now, how not, I'm gonna leave you with a couple cool shots of this great JGMAKER Magic 3D printer. Really cool, huh? Now we're gonna get it ready for the first print. So the first step we need to follow
is to tighten all the thumb screws of the heated bed all the way through to bring it down all that we can before the first outer home. Okay, I think that will be enough. Next, I'm going to remove the sticker covering the power port.
As you can see, it says that it's ready for 220 volts. If your network, for example, features 110 volts, you'll need to move the switch in the power supply to 110 volts.
I'm just going to remove it and plug in the power cable just like so. Next, I'm going to turn it on from the power switch at the left back, and after a few seconds, the home screen will appear. We'll be able to control it via the knob we have on the right. So for example, I'm gonna go to prepare and make an outer home. As you can see, the printer will automatically home every axis.
Right now, the printer is at the coordinates 000, and now I'm gonna check the maximum dimensions we could get in every axis.
So we'll go to prepare, move axis, Z, and I'm gonna go all the way up. As you can see, the maximum is 250 millimeters. For the y-axis, the max will be 223 mm, as you can see in the LCD panel. And for the x, the max will be 236 mm.
These values are gonna be very useful when we create our printer profile in Cura. By the way, I recommend you to watch the 2019 Cura Advanced Settings series, clicking here in the top right corner or in the link in the description. What I'm gonna do next is to load the filament for the first print. So the first thing I'm going to do is to center the x-axis so you'll be able to watch it better.
For that, we'll go to prepare, move axis, X, 10 mm, and I will move it to, for example, 116 mm. As you can see, the printer will automatically move to the coordinates we set on the screen. For the first print test, I'm going to use this amazing amber PETG provided by Sakata 3D Filaments, as an official sponsor of the Architects 3DP Mega 3D printer.
I'm sure you don't want to miss the build of this monster, clicking here in the top right corner or in the link in the description.
As you may know, the filament goes here in the spool holder, and to load it, I'm going to insert it a little bit through the filament sensor and feeder.
This time I'm going to load it manually to show you how to do that, but in the prepare menu, there is an option that says change filament, which is way much easier to do, just following the assistant on the LCD screen.
So to do it manually, we'll go to prepare, reheat ABS, since PETG is very similar to ABS in temperatures, and we'll choose preheat ABS end. As you can see, the target temperature has been set to 233 degrees, and we'll need to wait till the nozzle temperature here at the bottom reaches that temperature. Once it reaches the temperature, we'll push it till it starts going out of the nozzle right here. When it starts becoming hot, you can see that the black PLA inside the nozzle is starting to come out. Now that we have reached the 235 degrees, we'll press in the idler of the feeder and we'll start pushing filament all the way in until we see that it's getting to the extruder block, as you can see here. Once inside the extruder, we'll push a bit more and it will start coming out of the nozzle.
Okay, so the filament is loaded and ready, but there is one more step that we need to do before starting our first print. This step will be, as you can guess, to level the bed.
So we'll go to prepare, out to home, as we did before. Once in the home position, we'll go to prepare, disable steppers. So now we'll be able to move them manually without breaking the stepper motors. At this point, we'll grab a piece of paper and we are going to move the extruder to each of the four corners. You have to release pressure from the thumb screw at the bottom, till you can still move the paper, but you can feel a bit of friction in between the nozzle and the bed. So here we have one. Two. Three. And the last corner. You should repeat this process one more time to make sure it's perfectly leveled.
Now that the printer is leveled and the filament properly loaded, I'm gonna start the first print to check out the quality of this cool 3D printer.
So now I'm going to take the SD card from the included SD card reader and insert it into the machine, as you can see, upside down. Next we'll go to print from SD and select the G-code file that was included from the factory. The printer will automatically go to the home position and start the print.
And we're gonna see the result in the next video, where I'll make the review and comparison of this nice JGMAKER Magic 3D printer from JGAURORA. Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects 3DP if you still haven't, hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this video so more people will be able to enjoy with this project. And as always, a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp, clicking here in the top right corner, or in the link in the description. Remember that becoming a Patreon, you will get access to all the necessary components for this project, as well as all the past projects in the channel, and much more rewards that you can check in our Patreon page. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video!